Get away from there. You got a clean house.
Hello, Commissioner Boff. Hello, Mr. Merritt.
Send them.
Hey,
I guess your email.
Well, that's what he's gonna do.
I had a voicemail problem on the way down here. He just wanted to make sure we got that.
Hi, Greg. What's your name?
I got
good?
Yeah.
Doing great.
Yeah. Okay.
Hey, Randall.
Hey, how are you?
He said that the least expensive one was $75, $110. Well, just let me look at it.
Thanks for coming.
Got an extra?
$75, $110.
Oh, that's all right.
But he didn't give me detail.
Yeah, he's got some. He's got some on too. 20, I think it said 20, 30, and 40.
Yeah.
And 40 wasn't a little higher there, right?
It'd probably be close.
We think it's close.
Yeah. You know what we might do, and we can talk to him about this later. We got time. You know, it doesn't have to be continuous. We might just do it in stages and do the smallest one first and have it designed so we can make it cut out and expand it over time.
It's that great price you got.
Nothing's on there for grass.
Right. So we could, you know, we could expand it over time and make it sort of a project that has. So expansion takes place.
And this is 40 was full.
Yes, right. Thank you. You're welcome. We're excited to get a pass.
No, I think 40 was full.
I'll ask that.
Grand Oak.
When he puts it to the corner up there.
Remember, we said that's built. Yeah, we said that's about 40. Remember?
24, that was 40.
For Ralph.
And that was about the whole week.
They got a RJ, that's me. Sure.
But the key is driver's license.
Yeah, that's your driver's license. That's an ID.
Put this up anyway.
Right, put in the infrastructure. Again, if we do that and lay it out in such fashion that all we got to do is add on and let it slow back.
Are you sir?
And the water being come in the center. It'd be easy to expand the thing. I had two.
Well, it's just the amount of money. I mean, even if we got money, you don't want to get too. Well, we still want some reasonable price.
Right. No, I understand.
It means a lot of money no matter what.
Yeah.
It really is. Speaking of money, how are you doing?
I'm good. How are you? We might make me a deal. We might get some private parties.
Yeah, I think that's what.
Lots of different increases. Different size of variation.
That's a great deal.
I'm not sure. Ben was coming into town yesterday, so I'm not sure if he's going to be here.
Do we have a quorum?
We do.
Oh, we do. We'll go ahead and call the meeting to order. We have a quorum this morning. We'll start as we always do with us. Please stand and we'll pledge allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Randall, just so we know everybody in the room, I think everybody knows everybody else. Would you introduce your two guests there?
Yes, sir. Two guests with us, Simone and Emily, are with Scientific Games, and they'll give a brief presentation about their recent expansion that they've made in a moment.
Great. Thank you. Thank you for being here. We appreciate it. Okay. If you'll take a look at the, I think you got a copy of the minutes. Are you seeing the minutes? If you haven't, look over them quickly, and I'll entertain a motion to approve.
I make a motion we approve the minutes of the last meeting.
Do I hear a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor signify by aye.
Aye.
Opposed by nay. Thank you. Minutes are approved. Secretary of Treasury report, Pam. You said Pam will not be here?
No, but I have passed out the Secretary of Treasury report. Everybody should have a copy.
Okay, if you would, just take a look at it. I doubt that's changed much from last month. Have you seen anything there?
No, it hasn't changed. Not a lot of activity other than payment of a little interest, both sides.
Okay. All right.
$34,424.34 in operating account. $760.85 in the economic development account. We are solvent, on good financial footing.
Very good. Do we need to approve?
Yes.
I think we ratified.
Do we have to do that? Okay. I hear a motion to approve.
Have some move. Second.
Second, any discussion? All in favor, signify by aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed by no. Thank you. The treasurer's report is approved. Look at the contact sheet that's in front of you. I asked Angie just to give us an update so we'll all know how to get in touch with each other. So take a look at the numbers, and there's an email and some phone numbers on there, and make sure yours is right. If not, just correct and hand it back to Angie, and she'll put that on email. We'll have available email also. Okay? Thank you, Angie, for doing that.
You're welcome.
That helps me a great deal. Randall, I'll turn it over to you, and we'll go in here about time to begin.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Our community has been very successful in the first quarter with seeing great economic development projects. Currently, we've worked with four projects that are forecasted to generate just under 100 new jobs and right around $9.7 million in new capital investment. But one of the major projects that has taken place within our community has been a recent increase in the amount of technology and printing capabilities at Scientific Games. And we were joking earlier, I feel like for the past month, almost every week, we've been at Scientific Games, kind of doing just what we're doing today. We want to make sure we provided the board with an opportunity to learn about what our third largest employer in the community is doing and some of the recent advancements that they've had in terms of technology. So I'd like to introduce Simone and Emily just to speak to you briefly.
If we hear this presentation, we're not disqualified from buying a lottery ticket. We can still do that, right? I just want to make sure.
And did you bring samples with you?
I did. They're voided tickets, though. I'm not allowed to buy any real tickets, right? So we brought some sort of brochures that talk a little bit about our history of innovation. We just celebrated our 40th year last year. And then some sample tickets that you can look and hold on to, and then a picture of the there's some more informational material in here for you, but a picture of the press that we just had the ribbon cutting a couple of weeks ago, and the governor came, and we had the great honor of the governor helping us celebrate the launch of this new manufacturing technology along with Georgia Lottery Director Debbie Alford. So I'll leave this here for you. And I just prepared some notes, so I'll just take you through these, and I'm glad to answer any questions. So good morning. On behalf of Scientific Games, I'd like to thank the Development Authority of Forsyth County and the Forsyth County Chamber of Commerce for inviting us here this morning to share an update on our recent launch of manufacturing technology. A little background on our company. We moved from Michigan to Georgia about 30 years ago, and then 20 years ago, we chose Forsyth County as our development site for the new plant that we built 20 years ago. And we've expanded that plant multiple times over our history, going out the side and up the top, and really a reflection of our growth in providing lottery games to the world's lotteries. The instant lottery ticket that you see in front of you, it's really like a paper machine. It's uniquely programmed with security and designed with 20 layers of proprietary coatings, all ultimately connected to a consumer over a complex manufacturing process. And the launch of our Alpha P7 new technology a couple of weeks ago, it represents 20 individual flexographic printing presses linked by fiber optics and servo motors that move recyclable paper, receiving water-based inks, which are environmentally friendly, all laying down the science of the game at speeds of about 900 feet per minute. This technology is designed to maintain quality tolerances within 5 millimeters all across 6 football field lengths of paper. On this rapidly moving paper, each ticket has unique patterns of prizes, play action, and security, all applied by computer-controlled inkjet presses, orchestrating over a billion dots per second, linking both sides of the ticket. Our progress in community. We're very proud to live and work in Forsyth County and be part of the Georgia business community. With a 20-year perspective on the growth of Forsyth, quite simply, just wow. This community has grown all around us, and we've watched many companies come around us in recent years. At the Alpharetta Forsyth campus, we have 1,100 employees, all specializing in manufacturing, game development, software, web and mobile development, chemistry, hardware, really just a very long list of expertise.
and these professionals support our customers here in Georgia and in over 120 jurisdictions worldwide. And our mission, 40 years ago, we created the first secure instant lottery ticket for the Massachusetts Lottery. What was then designed to sell out in a year sold out in just a matter of weeks, and the modern phenomenon that is now the instant game was born. 40 years later, over $600 billion in global sales and $180 billion returned to good causes and charitable programs, the instant game that you see in front of you has become a major driver of growth for the lottery industry. Last year, worldwide sales of instant games were approximately $76 billion, and today at Scientific Games, we support this global industry with games and technology and services. Looking closer to home, we're very proud of our customer, the Georgia Lottery, and it is a clear industry leader in many areas. Georgia has the second highest per capita instant sales in the world, and the most phenomenally successful program in the Hope Scholarships. So in closing, the technology we launched here in Forsyth is a link to a complex chain that takes a fun chance for a prize and turns that fun chance into funds for education, the environment, and good cause programs. How much? This year, our new technology in Alpharetta will manufacture over $5 billion in prizes and $2 billion in funds for good causes. Thank you very much.
How many states and countries do y'all provide lottery tickets for?
Yep, 120 lottery jurisdictions, and just about every state in the United States is a customer of Scientific Games.
Wow. I sure are glad you're here.
Thank you.
I think for one of your, maybe it was your last expansion, the Development Authority did revenue bonds to finance that. Is that correct? I think you're currently...
Yes, it is.
I think they're still outstanding, so we still have an investment.
They've added to them as they bring new product online. We've been privileged to help them.
Right.
Would you like some more while you're here?
I've toured that plant, and it's just overwhelming what is made there.
Yeah.
You focus on one little lottery ticket, but what it goes through over there is just incredible.
It's complex, very complex science.
And the security, and that's like lunch before.
I'm telling you, yeah.
They've got good security.
Printing money.
Yeah, you're right.
Printing money.
You're right.
That's right. Do you have any idea, you're 1,100 employees, do you have any idea where they live?
I think we looked at that at one point, and 60 to 70%, I believe, are all in the Forsyth County area.
Just curious, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And they can't buy a lottery ticket, correct?
Isn't that right?
Sir. That's amazing.
Yeah. We say we win every 2 weeks when we get paid. So
there
that
you
works
go. That's a good place to work. That's a good place to work.
That's right.
There you go. That's exciting. But we're glad you're here. That's exciting.
Well, thank you very much for having us.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
Glad to see you grow.
Thank you.
And for signing. Thank y'all so much for being here today. And you're welcome to stay for the meeting. It won't last long. Okay, we want to get an update on the assisted living, the improved living, which I never can remember this name, by the way. Improved Living Town Club Windermere. Is that right? Is that the correct name?
That's correct.
That's the official name. And I know they have been trying to close. You want to give us an update?
Just as an update, and again, taking off our Development Authority Council hat, we are representing that group, our firm is representing that group, so we're reporting on behalf of them and not the Development Authority. But The closing has been bumped out to the first week of April. There are folks actually in town now doing due diligence from other parts of the country who are checking out the property, doing all sorts of their final due diligence, but the closing is scheduled for the first week of April.
If all goes well, then it's going to be a pretty soon start date.
The hope is to break ground within 3 days of closing.
Wow.
They're sitting them ready.
They are ready
to go.
Do you know what the final amount of the bonds are that they will want to issue?
The last, my understanding is it's about $128 million.
28.
What do we authorize?
Up to $145 million.
Okay.
So they're not using
all of it, but most of it.
But to the Development Authority, with the 1/8 1% fee, right. That's $160,000 for the Development Authority to get the bond issued.
Gotcha. Okay. Very good. Thank you. I appreciate it. I asked Randall to kind of give us a recap. We did get funded by the county, and we verified that last week. So I asked Randall to kind of give us an update of our budget that we're going to use this year with the county's funding.
Sure. Okay. Members of the board, what's been passed around to you is a copy of the document that was submitted during the budget proposal process, and that was approved by the county. See, it's a requisition for a request rather for $40,000 in total. And on the left, you kind of have the itemized breakdown. The center column gives more of an explanation of what each of those items are. And the far right column has the tally of what the total cost would be. Going through it, the first thing, of course, is our CoStar project. Last year, we were actually able to increase the response time for site selection requests by about 40% by using the CoStar software. So we believe that's an added value. The chamber, as we mentioned before in previous meetings, will be the recipient of the bills for that, and then we'll submit a request to the development authority for drawings on a quarterly basis. In addition to that, we're taking a look at a third-party analysis of Forsyth County's market. It's been quite some time since we've taken a look at where our strongest industry sectors are, and the nature of our global economic system continues to change. So we feel that since it's been about 5 years since the last one was done, now would be a sufficient time to explore that. The number there in terms of the dollar amount, I think, would be a very flexible number. There's more groups now in the community that are able to provide that service, including University of Georgia, the University of North Georgia now, and Georgia Tech as well. We're also taking a look at a third-party analysis of our tax digests, just to see where the balances are and what the forecasted shifts would be. That was a request that was made by the authority last year. But then marketing material. Much of our marketing material that's used to market our target industries of the manufacturing, healthcare, technology, data center, and international sectors is due to be updated. So we put an allocation in there for marketing material to be developed and created. And then the fall conference is noted here on the sheet. The Georgia Economic Developers Association Fall Conference is actually the only event each year where we'll have, at the same time, simultaneously, the presence of state and federal elected officials, project managers who work in each of our target industries, as well as potential clients. And we feel that it's very suitable for us to be there so that way we can work on closing out many of our projects for the fourth quarter during that conference. And the Development Authority asked us to reach out to several of our local healthcare practitioners, as well as our medical equipment manufacturers in the community, and ask them what was the premier conference that they went to in order to do recruitment and to actualize their goal of meeting new vendors. And the FIME conference that takes place in Florida was actually the premier one that was recommended. So we have an allocation here for us to cover the cost of going to the FIME conference, and that'll provide us with the gateway to recruit more medical equipment manufacturers to the community. So in all, it comes out to about $40,000 in total. We're already on track to stay very on point with the budget, and as you might recall, our goal is always to be as conservative as possible with how we're spending the dollars and make sure we're spending them for the public's good.
Very good, thank you. So we can look forward to another presentation by yourself and Lynn, as we heard last time.
Yes, about how a disruptive force is being
some disruptive innovation.
Well, I'll look forward to it myself.
Randall, one comment I would make.
Yes, sir.
It would probably be good to rank these or put priorities on these in case something comes up that we have to adjust. We know which one we want to shift out to the latter part of the year or maybe bump. You know, last year we had that kind of unexpected expense come up on the Georgia Tech survey regarding the traffic pattern down in the south end of the county. We probably want to hold a little in reserve to loan toward the end of the year in case something like that comes up that we have to bump something.
Can do.
So I don't think I'd obligate everything up front, but maybe put a priority on it and go down a priority list. So if we have something that changes that priority, we've got the ability to move around and shift things.
Absolutely.
What month is the GEDA?
September.
September?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Okay. Thank you, Bob. Thank you. Any other questions? Randall? Thank you very much. Okay. the fountain project. As you all know, we at Development Authority, we are pursuing the idea of funding the fountain over at the new courthouse. Doug Deere worked with us this week and had the project team over there actually lay out the fountain. We've been talking about a round fountain, but really what they had laid out over there was a curved rectangle, I guess the best way I can say, an arch. And they laid it out, and really that fits the front of the building. We looked at, Bobby and I and Doug and part of the project team went over there in the mud, walked in the mud, and they had laid it out and we looked at it. However, for what we had budgeted, and they told us this beforehand, they had looked at it and looked at the footprint, and for what they could build, for what we had budgeted, it was very small. It looked small. It looked small in front of the building. It just didn't fit from architecturally. So they played with it a little bit, and we laid out some two befores and looked what would look more reasonable. So they've run some preliminary numbers to see what it would cost, and what we had budgeted was $75,000, and from the Development Authority to build this fountain. So we looked at expanding it, and today we did get some preliminary numbers. We were looking at this arch basically about 20 by 10 of a fountain that was arched, and that was too small. So he did a cost for doing 30 by 10 and 40 by 10. And it probably looks best at 40 by 10, but preliminary numbers, that takes that cost to about $140,000. So we're gonna get back with him. There's some questions we have.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Get an idea of what we're talking about. I wasn't going to put you on the spot.
No, that's,
I'm glad you
no, that's fine. I wanted you all to see the you asked for the rendering, right. And
it
you asked for.
It helps to visualize. Yeah,
it helped tremendously to go on site earlier this week.
Right, yeah, it sure did.
Well, when you saw it laid out, it just really wasn't. It wasn't big enough. It really wasn't. So we certainly are going to pursue the funding issue. We got a few questions we got to ask them about. Can you partially do it? Can you do part of it? This area you see the fountain in, and you see what I'm talking about, the arch, just a curved arch. This area to be in the fountain, if there wasn't a fountain, they would simply grass it. It would just be grass. So it could actually be done later, and we think it could actually be done, you could do part of it, and then you could expand it, and we have some questions. Now, those are not things we would like to do, because it just would make sense to get it done, whatever we're gonna do. But we have a few more questions for the architect, and plus for him to really finalize the numbers of what it takes to do this. The good news for us is that we, in talking to Doug, in the plan for the building already, in the budget for the building and in the plans, is the water and power and drainage. That was included to be done to that area anyway. And we were on a pretty tight deadline, March 31st, yes, we needed to make a decision. And to be honest, it's a very minimal amount that's built in to do the water and the power. It's less than I thought. It's a very small amount of money. And Doug said at this point, since we've got some questions and we've got some funding questions, he is certainly okay with going ahead and putting that in out there. So it doesn't put us in quite the panic. Have you had a change of heart since we
No, not at all. Not at all. We'll put the infrastructure in for it, the utilities. And then you can either plan to do it at a later date, or since we have a decision made about including the infrastructure, if you had some follow-up questions and needed a little more time beyond March 31st, we could probably get that time. So if in maybe mid-April at the latest, if you made a decision about doing it during construction, I think that'll give us time to build the plan into the current plan, make modification to it, both architecturally and otherwise. So if you need some additional time to look at this, to have some of your other questions answered, I think mid-April would be okay. I think we can make really good time.
And of course, we also need a closing on our project. But anyway, Doug, thank you for the infrastructure will be there. Doesn't put us in the panic. I think Bobby and I, after looking at it, both agreed that this shape of a fountain fit the building so much better than having a small round fountain sitting out there. This really looks like what ought to be there when you look at it. And it'll be your typical pool of water nozzles with a fountain. And hopefully people throw lots of money in it. And
this drawing here that you see shows the center arch is what 20 feet would look like. The whole arch would be approximately 40 feet. So, and you can look at this and kind of put it in perspective. You only did half of that arch of the pool that's shown here is what 20 feet would look like. So it always grows, but I think 40 feet would be appropriate. If you haven't had a chance, I was impressed when I walked out there. You can look at this drawing, and that's a drawing. But you walk out there on the ground and stand and look at how big this building is and how tall it is. Mm-hmm. A 20-foot fountain looks like a weight.
It looks pretty tiny. It did.
I mean, when you look at the scale of it, I think anything less than 40 feet would look pretty dinky.
And what you're looking at now, you got one more floor to go.
That's right.
What's out there now. So
it is massive.
Yeah, it's a big deal. But anyway, I think we've at least hemmed this up to where we're headed. It fits the building. And we'll just do a little more homework. A few more questions we want to ask the architect, and then we'll talk about funding, Bobby. So at least at this point, we're not in a panic. We got some time, and we'll try to have this. We'll do some more work on this, Bobby, and the funding part of it. We may look at some other private funding. We have some other groups like the Rotaries who have an interest in doing something, and it might be to help us on this if we want to expand this fountain.
And a comment there. I talked to Mike Smith in our Rotary Club who's heading up the project, and his goal is to raise $15,000 minimum from the Rotary Club. And we're applying for a matching grant with the Rotary Foundation for another $15,000. So hopefully we wind up with a $30,000 budget for benches and accessories around this. He's tentatively looking at maybe granite benches that will be mounted on the pad so they're permanent. You know, those things will last forever. Rather than getting something that has to have maintenance or be refurbished over time. So the Rotary Club, I think, will come through with a lot of the decorations, benches, or whatever else we do, flower pots, whatever we decide to do around this. So it should be an attractive focal point in front of the building there.
And also, though, you might mention what you've done with the bench locations. You've already had the project team look at where they would go.
Yes. We need to prep the site for architecturally and construction-wise for the benches. So the architectural team is currently looking at, based on this rendering and based on the plans, where the benches should go aesthetically and flow-wise. So we expect to have that at our next Tuesday meeting, which is a construction meeting we have every Tuesday. So we'll have that very soon. That'll show you where the benches will go, and that will also show, obviously, the number of benches that makes sense for the size building.
We talked about at some point you want to say stop. Stop the benches. Because I think what you would have is lots of groups wanting to say, okay, I want a bench. But what we're going to do is up front say, here's where they're going to go. Here's what we have funded. This we're going to have.
How many do you think there'll be? Do you have any idea?
I don't. I don't. I think there are some shown in the rendering.
Here.
Yeah, there's just a couple here. I think there's some discussion. We'll shred that when you leave. We don't want that to be evidence. There has been discussion about adding some benches down in that area on both sides as well. So I am pretty confident that will be more than those four that are shown on this rendering.
You might ask Mike when you see him. I think he has gotten a preliminary quote on what the benches would cost installed. And that's something we'll have to coordinate to install. These heavy grants, you can't just carry them out there and set them down. We'll have to have equipment during the construction phase to set those in place. But you can find out from him what they are and look at a $30,000 budget and get a rough idea of how many benches we're talking about.
And I guess we would also ask, we really hadn't talked about, I think a granite bench is the most uncomfortable bench in the whole world. But I guess we look for some guidance from the project team, again, from an aesthetic and architectural view, what is the best thing to, I mean, there's some nice benches that aren't granite.
Right. But, sure. And I think Mike is open at this point to suggestions. What he was looking at is something that's permanent.
Yeah.
That doesn't require continual maintenance or upkeep or whatever. But I don't know that he's settled on any one final answer yet.
And this is one of the drawings from, or pictures from, when Brad Ewing came in and presented.
Oh, he did.
To you. That's one of the pictures he brought. That's just another style. However, with the classic look of the courthouse, the recommendation from the project team was to consider concrete, that look, concrete or granite, just that look, that classic look. However, they are less comfortable, no doubt about that. So
we want people to linger there.
Nobody will sleep on them, I guess.
But what I can do is after, once the construction team, architectural committee team gets together, talk about this next Tuesday or maybe the following Tuesday, I can get you some information regarding their the number of benches, the placement, and possibly even some additional pictures or renderings of the benches that would be aesthetically pleasing and fit in with the classic look of the courthouse.
I know this is getting ahead of ourselves, but what happens if we have more organizations wanting as far as the benches than we have spaces?
Spots. It'd be a nice problem, I guess.
Would it be a nice problem?
We
could put them over at the jail.
Apply it to any shortfall you have with the fountain. If they wanted to, if they chose to do that, you could. I don't know if there'd be an interest in. If you do have that problem, which is a good problem, maybe there's two placards on benches that there's donations from a number of people instead of just one person or one group. That would be entirely up to you.
It'd be a nice problem to have.
It would be.
Kind of like Bob was talking, we laughed about it, but the grant from the Rotary, it's for submitting it for benches, but you know, you could really say there's benches around that fountain. So,
yes.
I'm just saying.
No, that's true.
I mean, funding the fountain. I mean, I don't think we have any problem with help on the fountain, if that's what we need to
I'll pass that on to Mike.
The bottom line is our budgeted amount that we've agreed on is really not going to construct a big enough fountain. And I think we're agreeing. And if you'll trust Bobby and I on that, when we looked at it, you could tell. It's just tiny.
It looked totally out of place.
It looked out of place.
It needs to be bigger.
So thank you for your help.
You're welcome.
And we'll continue to work on it.
Yes, sir.
And you can go ahead with the infrastructure part of it. So.
And I think, David, if you don't mind, one more thing. I think the timing is just right. The architectural committee and the construction team work on what I was talking about earlier, the benches, the placement, and the fountain, we will probably be able to bring that very soon to the project team. We would obviously want to hear from the development authority first. If you're going to move forward with the program, with this initiative, we would take that to the project team. And it would at some point go to the Board of Commissioners for approval as well. So the timing might be just right. We plan on having a project team meeting probably sometime in April.
Okay, perfect. And thank you, you're exactly right. It does have there is kind of a three-step process.
Yes, sir.
From the authority to the team to the commissioners.
So yes, sir.
We'll try to have all our ducks in a row to get that done. So, all right, any other questions about the fountain? I think we've made some progress. We're not at the end yet, but we've made good progress.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay.
Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, any comments? Any
no,
comments
sir.
From the board?
Sounds good. Looking forward to seeing the fountain and all the seats out there, and I appreciate that. It's going to make the place a lot more, I guess, fitting well. Anything we can do to help, especially landscaping, the benches and the fountain, it's going to all look good. Thank you.
Well, and I think one thing that you can, if you get any criticism for the budget on it, you can deflect that by stating that this is non-taxpayer funds.
Yes,
this is not coming out of the taxpayers' pockets in Forsyth County.
That's true.
So it may be important if criticism comes up that private enterprise is funding this, not the taxpayers.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Let me ask one question, Bob. Was that all the Rotary clubs combined, the 15,000, or just?
That was my understanding from Mike, but we might clarify that when we see him. Was that just what our Rotary club was going to put in, or was that what he was looking at from all of the Rotary clubs?
Okay. Okay.
Good question, yeah.
Have you talked about in your club, Joanne? Mm-hmm.
I think it's all because the last meeting, Penny Penn attended to represent Sal. But Renee invited all five presidents to that meeting, our last development authority.
But I think that was a combined budget.
I do too. Okay. I think it's combined.
And I did talk to Mike earlier this week, and he said it was all five. Mm-hmm. And it was a total of $15,000.
Okay.
Plus the potential of the $15,000 grant.
Yeah.
Okay. I think those are submitted in April this year.
So it's kind of
the same. Yeah, I think Mike said it had to be in this month, the request. So we should know next month.
Mike, would you update Mike? Would you kind of fill him in on where we are?
Yeah, I'll see him at lunch.
And because he doesn't know about all this.
Right.
Why don't you let him know where we are and what we may be looking at. So,
okay.
Very good. All right, thank y'all. Any other matters to come before the authority today?
No, I just want to say to Pete, the Board of Commissioners, and Doug, and your project team, this is a first-class project. I think this represents our county well. This will be something we all can be proud of, and y'all have done a great job on this.
Thank you, sir.
Both the courthouse and the jail.
I hope you've noticed the parking deck going up, how fast it's going up, but it looks really great. That brick outlay outside of it, so it's going to be an attribute to City of Cumming.
It really is.
We're going to have a new downtown.
Right. And parking is always a problem. It's going to help.
It is. And contrary to popular belief, you remember when we did the mock-ups during the SPLOS campaign, the buildings were orange and purple. Contrary to popular belief, they are not orange and purple. Looking back, that probably wasn't a good idea.
or having the black hole.
Yeah, that's right. So anyway, I echo what Tim said. Thank you. It's a great project. I'm excited. I've never stood on ground level and looked right there at that front. It's going to be cool. It really is going to be pretty. Really is going to be nice. Something to be proud of. Okay. All right, any other matters? Anything else to come before the authority? Do I hear a motion?
I make the motion we adjourn.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank y'all very much.
Thank you.
Being adjourned.
I appreciate you guys working with us.
Okay. It's going to look good over there.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that
you're winning $1 million, but
so that's what I was looking to see. I got to do since it's no good. This will be a winner.
I'm living it right now. My in-laws are moving into town to be close to the grandkids, so that's the way everybody's
doing. Okay. This was one of my tickets. I didn't get a single number.
That's fine.
Thank you. Not a single one.
And McClure group, that's where I was there. Thing that we're last night. I have no idea what her she is.
What you filming, girl?
The agenda. I used that as the title for my video at the beginning.
Oh, there you go. Well, that's smart. Just do it right off there. You don't get too much glare, huh?
Exactly. It works pretty well.